I would like to talk about a very common question that patients ask is, what is a bone graft? And a bone graft is what we are using to help weld parts of the spine together in a fusion-type surgery. So to answer the question, we first need to understand what bone is made of. And there's basically two parts of bone. There's a very hard cortical rim, and that is where the structure of bone comes from. So that if I push down on this bone, it doesn't collapse. That mostly comes from the cortical bone, which is harder, and it feels like tapping on the table. The inner part of the bone, which is called the cancellous bone. Cancellous bone is where most of your blood is actually made. It is your bone marrow. Patients that have osteoporosis basically have the same amount of cortical bone. They just don't have much cancellous bone on the inside. When we talk about obtaining bone graft, we need two things typically. We need something that involves structure to provide structure to our construct. The second is we need all that good healing bone marrow inside. And that comes from the cancellous portion of bone. So many of us will then harvest a piece of this bone from either the patient, or it may come from a bone bank. Many patients ask, where does the bone come from? And it comes from generally the same bank where people donate their corneas, their skin, their heart, their liver to others after they pass. That also donate their bones. Many patients ask, well, why don't, doesn't the bone graft have to be matched? And that is very specific to bone. When they prepare bone, they actually clean it from all of the cells. And therefore we're left with just the structural portion of bone and none of the cellular content. That is a good thing and allows us to be able to utilize that bone without having to match it. However, it also presents a challenge because there are no cellular elements, and therefore the bone is dead for all practical speak. So we need to somehow liven it up. Many of us will obtain some bone marrow or use some of the bone spurs, as well as utilizing a needle to get some of the bone marrow to help mix with that bone graft to liven it up. When the bone comes from the bone bank, oftentimes there's two ways that it comes. It can come, this is what is called a cervical graft, and there is a hard piece of bone that helps give it structure to prevent compression. And then there is the cancellous portion, which is the soft portion of bone, and that's what tends to heal first. The downside of utilizing some of these grafts is that it can take a longer period of time to incorporate, and therefore we may lose some of the structure. So many surgeons will utilize either a spacer cage, either made of plastic as this one, or metal such as this one, because that substitutes for the cortical portion of bone. But then they pack cancellous bone down inside. And it's that cancellous bone that will then basically grow through and attach to the vertebra above and vertebra below it. And that is the completion of a fusion.